Radiant Team Pick. Okay, welcome back to the Frankfurt Major 2015 Open Qualifier. The road for Empire. Are they able to win this game and still have this chance to get through there? Or will they also lose the second game in this best of three series? And will Big Red Machine, aka Screen Squad, be the team that will go through to the qualifiers? With me is @StrikeDota, and let's see how it all goes as we see the basic opening coming up for Team Empire.
Yep, this time it's gonna be Empire that have the Shadow Fiend. Let's see if he's gonna prove to be the deciding factor. But Big Red Machine stick to what worked for them, and they first pick the Tiny this time. Perhaps anticipating that Empire is gonna be banning it out in the second phase, and they just don't wanna give him the chance.
And they pick up they pick the Bane up straight away as well. They really value this control that you can bring out with him, especially in laning phase.
Yeah, just very strong early game heroes that have a lot of kill potential. I think that's the most important thing, being able to, you know, get pickoffs with multiple combinations and not always relying on the same one or two heroes. Gives you more, yeah, more maneuverability in the early game.
Yeah, that also means that you actually can't really get a one, like a solo offlaner anymore. Just because if you're even close to the creeps, he just nightmares you and whoever is on the lane can most likely follow it up. Yep. So you always have to have somewhere around. It's the same as when you have a Shadow Shaman. You can't really have a solo offlaner then as well, you have to go dual lanes.
I wonder if they're gonna put the Tiny mid again or have him safely in this time though. It should be quite difficult against the Shadow Fiend. And then again, that's the same thing we said about Quop, and I saw what happened last game.
I think, and Shadow Fiend is also quite squishy. I think on paper, Shadow Fiend is the better matchup than a Queen of Pain, just because there's no escape.
Yeah.
Like, if you get close to her, you can most likely stun her up and maybe throw her back or something, or just throw her up straight in the air and kill her.
Mm. Clockwork Harry, like this big though, it just makes it so difficult for Bane to use ultimate. He has so many ways to cancel it, and also Tiny does actually get controlled quite well by the Clockwork. He generally doesn't want to pick up a BKB until later, and even after the BKB hookshot and the cogs, they're still very annoying.
Yeah, even though the cogs don't push you back anymore, they're still in your way. And was it level 4 cogs need 3 hits, so...
Yeah, 3 hits. For a hero like Tiny that doesn't hit often, that's quite a big deal. And of course, it's just the general synergy between a hero like Shadow Fiend and Clockwork. Shadow Fiend stays in the back, drops his damage from far away, and Clockwork keeps the enemies at bay. Radiant
team pick. So now I've also finished my yogurt. It's really bad.
Ooh, I'm really dying.
Okay, we haven't seen this. I've actually not seen this hero throughout the entire... I don't think I've seen him throughout the entire Open Qualifier on my stream. Which surprises me a bit.
It could have been kind of predictable. They banned out both Gyro as well as Ember Spirit. Two heroes that can clear out zombies very well. But Empire took that to be... an incoming brute pick, they ran that instead of the inline.
Radiant team pick. And
see, why we picked up 6th, that's actually also kind of unusual, I feel. It's usually, like, the hero is very, very powerful, very valued a lot.
You would actually expect maybe Big Red Machine wanting to pick that one up somewhere down lane as well. It's actually gonna pick up a Luna here, I think.
I think they're already...
They want to go push, like, they want to go kill people.
Yeah, they've already kind of showed their hand now.
Yeah, they, this is
pretty
something
obvious
they,
what they're going for.
This is something that they have actually run before in the tournament. It seems like they've picked up Luna a bunch of times. 3 times already. Together with a Tiny twice as well. And a Bane as well. So, let's see, they're missing most likely...
Juggernaut.
A support hero. I don't want to go for Auras, we're going to be looking at a Vengeful, I would say. Since I've done that before, they've picked a hero up.
Yeah, Vengeful would fit quite nicely. And it's also going to bring them bring their physical damage. No, I mean, I like the Jugger pick because it's a hero with obviously innate magic immunity, means he can fight very early against the Luna and all the nuke damage. But on the other hand, the Blade Fury doesn't protect him from physical damage, and you know, with the Luna aura and with Bane right clicking quite hard for support, as well as the Tiny, you know, things can get hard for the Jugger.
Also, you still have the Bane Fiend's Grip that goes through it as well, so you can still get tossed away if they don't want to deal with you, or you can get tossed further in if they want to deal with you.
Exactly. So it's really not my ideal pick, but it's something.
Yeah, they end up choosing for it. Yeah, it could work out. Like, Luna is squishy as you can get it. Bane is also pretty susceptible to getting Omni Slash, so. Question is, you need to get close and and afterwards, level 6 Omni Slash might be a little bit troublesome. If Bane gets off one Brain Step in between the Omni Slashes on, let's say, a random creep or something, he should be able to survive through it. Luna is the only one who will most likely die instantly. 10 seconds remaining. I don't think she can survive.
5 seconds remaining. Yeah, Empire just missing one more support now. Actually, yeah, Big Red Machine as well. Baker gonna be banned out.
Is it gonna be Tiny that for sure? It might just be Tiny dying in the offlane. Tiny has been running in the offlane a couple of times before. Remaining. For example, by Sexy Bamboo.
Yeah, they will be able to apply a lot of pressure, of course.
Like Winter Griffin, Joe, I don't think they can kill them. Like, what would they be able to do against him dying and Tiny? Two of them, they will need a third support that's actually able to stand up as well. And what are you gonna get? A Lion?
No, Lion is not that powerful.
No, Rubick is not gonna work out either. Like, there are not many options left.
But I think they will stick to the Tiny mid though. You do want him to get fight farms. He does a lot with it.
And see if they can kill the Shadow Fiend again. This is a question of getting Winter Wyvern there, but you would love to get the big slow on top.
Yeah, and the early Blink Dagger on Tiny is just so powerful. Beastmaster.
Okay, they are going Auras, but
Beastmaster.
Single target here.
Yeah, so it's gonna be the Undying on the fourth position.
So it might just be. No, Beastmaster. We're gonna do Beastmaster offlane, I guess? Yeah. How's the Beastmaster versus Shadow Fiend matchup? Is it better than Tiny? I don't think so, right?
No, not really. He can actually bully him quite a bit early on with the Boris, just preventing CS. But you know, as soon as he gets the raises up, animals just die.
I should have better than
again.
Like, they just pick up the hero so many times because Alola then just plays him pretty well.
I mean, I have to admit, this is a slightly better Rubick game. The Eclipse is a pretty huge spell and it's quite easy to steal because there's a long cast point on Lucent Beam. But even then, I'm not sure if this is the right answer to this early aggression. Because after all, Rubick does need quite a bit of levels and items to, you know, be really effective. And he's more powerful in skirmishes than just straight up 5-on-5 fights.
Yeah, then he feels a bit squishy. So. Although it's nice to have that null field aura, but still there is more than enough physical damage coming out from BRM as well. So.
Yeah, and that aura is not really gonna be maxed until much, much later in the game.
Yeah, it's Midas. Rubick, maybe something new that could run here, but it's most likely not gonna work out. Man, he got a terrible gem in his thing. Who the hell wants Roshan kills in his Rubick staff?
Yeah, I guess he didn't really choose that himself. It's random, right, when you unwrap it.
Yeah, it's you don't really have a choice. You can still take it out and put a new one in. Or put others in X-ray in it. But yeah, let's just do a quick introduction since we really didn't do that last game. As we have here the road for Team Empire to the Frankfurt Major. We're gonna have start off here with Alola Dance on the Rubick. Silent is gonna be playing the Juggernaut first time this tournament. Yoku is gonna be playing the Shadow Fiend. No Fear is gonna be going on the Winter Wyvern, and that leaves Resolution on the Clockwork.
Right, Samuel. On the Radiant side, Big Red Machine, we have Sedoi is gonna be playing the Beastmaster. Screen on the Undying, ZXC on the Luna, Axmo again on the Tiny, let's see if he can perform as well as last game, and finally Slander on the Bane. Both the Tiny and the Bane are same heroes they had last game. So yeah, BRM just sticking to what they know.
And it worked out for them. We didn't really see the Bane ganking into mid to help the Tiny out. So I think once actually, but there was a sentry, which so it didn't really work out.
And he still did great against the Queen of Pain. But I think this game we'll see.
I don't think they're gonna get caught off. I think Yoko will play a little bit more conservative.
Yeah, but I don't think he's gonna get cut off, but the Bane is gonna pressure him more. Because Shadowfiend is really a hero, you don't want him getting ahead.
Yeah, it's nice to have these double boars there, but they're gonna get farmed as well at the same time.
Yeah, it looks like both teams putting their offlaners on the safe lane. Interesting. It looks like Sedoi is gonna pick up a TP scroll and they decided to run their...
Yeah, actually both teams want to run an aggressive, or at least they want to run tri-lane into tri-lane here. Who does his favor in the end?
I guess they're just waiting out to see what's going on. Yeah, Sedoi is gonna pick up the TP right away and go top.
Doesn't this favor BRM like by a lot, having a dying just in there?
Yeah, Undying is just the king of tri-lanes, and especially if you're the ones playing aggressive tri-lane into that, I really don't see them.
Like at level 2 they have a whole lot of kill potential. Hey, look at it, 400 HP on the on the Juggernaut. This has been away, a lower dance is even less, he has 350. Screen is taking a lot of damage from this, might as well look out a little bit there. Yeah, not
the
DK, but...
He almost had 20 HP.
Minus 10. The Juggernaut, just look at his strength, it's like absolutely nothing. I can't imagine it being any better for Rubick. ZK6 or whatever. That's it, this lane becomes dangerous from level 2. Luna and Steel doesn't really do a lot because Lunar Beam is just so weak at level 1.
Yeah, I mean, well, no fear. He went mid to help with Shadow Fiend, but you really need to help Shadow Fiend against the Tiny, and Tiny picked up his bottle anyway. Because he started with only 2 benches.
Sedoi here on top though is taking a lot of damage. You're able to slow him down pretty nicely, but having Rocket Flare and not Battery Assault is actually turning out to be a mistake.
It looks like Resolution was expecting an aggressive try-in as well.
And they switched it up. Good call there, because they wouldn't have been able to do anything against it. It does mean nothing. Yeah, there you go, dying straight up top.
Yeah, VRM not gonna let him get away with this.
It's just every time he gets silent low, he goes back to base, you just go back to base as well, get mana, get a TP and just follow him wherever you want to go.
Yep.
So low dance, casual stroll through mid, gets a tower hit, just keeps on walking top. Could have tried it, it didn't really matter in the end. As now it's Luna solo versus Resolution, so it should be okay, but... Level 6, Resolution should probably jump him and kill him. I would say the Battery Assault this game is maybe better over Rocket Flare. As in midway, actually,
what a mistake. Maybe not a mistake, that was just unfortunate. He realized that Rubick was coming in to help, so instead of going for the Shadow Fiend, which they could not have killed, he wanted to combo on the Rubick, a squishier target. But just as he did, Lower Dance attacked Yoku to take off the sleep, which made him invulnerable. So the avalanche hit, but the toss, when the Rubick is invulnerable, like the toss didn't count him as a valid target, so he tossed the creep instead, and did not have enough damage. It's just kind of an unfortunate series of events there.
And it doesn't really help you.
First blood still not gonna be spilled, 3 minutes in.
Yeah, both teams aren't really going that aggressive on each other, so don't really... Well, on top now, they're gonna go again with the tri-lane, now with the Beastmaster in it. Screen has level 2, so there isn't Toad. No, actually, what? Soul Ring? I guess with the recent buff to it. It got buffed, right? 180.
Yeah. So. Yeah, it's now 10 units, which is fairly easy to get in try. And it's 180 damage or heal. I think it's more valuable if you use as a heal.
I would say it's
because, of course,
the
damage
better.
Gets reduced.
Totem 1 though is not really, really shitty. It's like 3 hits or something from anything instead. Man, Silent is not having a fun time at all. Zedexia on the other hand has like double CS.
On screen.
Ooh, green, they throw him back. He can still get a DK off here. He gets it on 2, but he will in the end still take a fall here as he's going to be the first bot to get a second kill as well. Now Slender is able to at least get Silent back for it. But the lower dance, he's going to go deep. He's going to go balls deep. This might be... Okay, he's going to go Golden Race. Okay, rotation in. I'm pretty sure they know where lower dance is here. Yeah. Oh, what totem? That's a big commitment.
It's level. He knows he can't really use it in a bigger fight, because like you said, 3 hits, that's just... In trolling, that's one hero hits at once.
At least you... I don't think that was worth it either. Like, it's still a minute cooldown.
Yeah. Oh no, Empire getting the better deal out of that. Get the first blood, and they get a second kill before the Joker dies. Gets XP for all of that.
Yeah. At least that's
and meanwhile,
something.
Mid, we see as expected, Yoku really dominating the tiny. 36-19 up against the 12-1.
Yeah, he is not playing around anymore. After last game on the Queen of Pain, I think that hurts his ego a bit. Because he's really just full on denying and making sure that best the tiny can do is get some XP.
Yeah, exactly.
This Trine is most likely going to be the place where we're going to see some more deaths coming out. Are they fighting here? I don't think Exmo can do anything about it. No, he's returning already. It'll be really weird to do. Lunar Eclipse is up, but level 1 is still really underwhelming as Slender is going to be found. Nightmare is on
Razor. Nightmare.
That's weird. Okay, now Yoku is going to go in. He's going to get at least a kill here. One Yoku is still running away. No dance died there. Big spin to pass. Does nothing.
Big rotations from both teams. Ends up being just one kill on the lower dance.
Smartly placed totem there on the pillar.
Yep, no way to bring it down.
So pretty much everybody's just stuck here until the next TPs can come out. Mid is just being farmed up by Silent. He's finally heavy. He can finally get some CS. Still only 16 at 7 minutes in. That's not good at all.
Yeah, and Jugger, I mean, sure, his pulls are pretty decent. He can do quite a bit without items, but you definitely do want items on him. Sooner rather than later.
Resolution, yeah, I think he knows what's up. Alodance also rotates in. No chance to really follow this one up. Some pinging comes out. I'm not completely sure from which side it was. Now Silent is mid against Tiny. He's okay, I guess. Both sides are really, really scary. They're scared. Again, the face. Yeah,
the big difference here between Yoku's Shadow Fiend and ZXC's Shadow Fiend last game. 7 minutes in, he's already sitting at 68 CS.
Yeah, he's really farming it up. Zedoi's gonna get caught out and they're gonna farm this this totem up as well. Takes 4 hits, so it should be leveled up. Yeah, there you go.
Yoku gets the kill as well as the last hit on totem. It's another 100 gold. So it's starting to really shoot ahead of the Luna.
What do you think? He has a Ravepant. Is he gonna build into a Kilo or is he gonna go maybe for Yul's build? Maybe Flink, Mecha, or.
I think Akela is worth it here considering the physical damage lineup of BRM. I mean,
do you think? Really? Silent because Silent has one as well.
Yeah, but Akela is just such a cost effective item. It's not that bad to have two of them. Plus, anytime when you're looking to split push.
He got the Basilius on the career. He agrees with you and he's gonna go for Mecha afterwards, having the chainmail on the career.
Yeah. Yeah, just having the Akila mech combo gives you a lot of armor and it's definitely something you want against all the physical damage coming out from BRM.
Will take some time though. They're gonna set up for the Luna here, ZXC. 900 HP, currently sitting at 700. It's a prime target to go after. But I think they know something is up, sitting back here.
ZXC position very carefully. The rocket to potentially scout behind
But
the
will give
tower.
away the position, especially if you shoot
Ooh.
it from this angle.
They see Slender? No, they missed him. Wanna
Going
go mid
mid,
instead, but nice
Tiny is rotating
pings.
up. It's
Yeah. Good pings, BRM just, you know, signaling to go for the tower. They realize what's going on. There's no stacks to be stolen in their jungle.
Yeah, going into aggressive twilight like that early, early on does mean that there are no stacks, in, which in this case does more than work out in their favor.
And again, Empire doing these 4-man smokes, which are just quite predictable, and we can see them not working out. BRM just realized what's going on. They see that there's absolutely no one top. There's only a Juggernaut coming mid. And yeah.
The good thing for Empire is that they do push a little bit faster. At least until Luna comes and joins the fray here, but they're already rotating up. Yeah, Yoku gets an Invis rune and goes there as well. This might get up really big. Oh, he has no weapon of souls, never mind. Just level 8, and he's level 9 for that. Still, might get up a good position for raises and scout out as well. Yeah, they fight Esmo, but there's gonna be the rocket from Resolution coming in, but he just gets thrown back. Also, Silent now is now in the front. He was getting controlled, or no, he was just standing still and going around, but ZXC, he is gonna get cleaned up now. Loadens getting some kills there. Pretty nice. Screen. He's in the forest, he's gonna get out. Pretty nice space to go out from as an aggressive movement there from Resolution to pick up 2 kills turns into his own personal death.
Yeah, what happened with Silent TP in with Bait 3? He got immediately roared and right click down.
I thought he might have been Shadow. What was it? Shadow Fiend.
Fiend's Grip.
Yeah, Fiend's Grip.
No, but, 6 yet.
Yeah, so I was wondering what the hell it was, why it was standing still. Yeah, that explains it.
Yeah, but I don't know, overall, I think the fight definitely favored Empire. Him taking a lead now and Jeremy Silent dying yet again, it's not that great, but you know, he's holding on a little bit in terms of farm. But meanwhile, if you look at Yoko's net worth, it's well ahead of both the Luna and the Tiny. And that mech is gonna be ready soon. And meanwhile, we have no one going for the mech inside of Radiant, as Beastmaster is watching the Necrobook. We expect it, but that does leave him without the mech. And if they do keep going for these 5-on-5 fights, you know, the team with mech is gonna have a massive advantage.
Still, it's still undying though, what you're against, so even if you have a mech, it's under attack. I guess you can heal it up faster because you have less strength. I guess you could also make that.
Yeah.
It looks more impressive if you get healed half your health due to the fact that you have no strength.
Yeah, I hope we get to see. It is a position 4 in my FM. I hope we get to see an Aghanim's on in this game. I still think that's one of the most broken things in the game right now. Stealing 10 strength.
That said, you can't go for this first item. That's kind of. That doesn't work either, especially if you have Tranquil Boots. Like, you don't have the mana to really sustain those decays. That said, if you keep it at level 1, though, it might work, but then you don't have the. It's a little bit less spammable as well, so it's. I haven't done math on that one. So.
I mean, usually by the time he gets the Aghanim, he also has more levels, so you have enough mana to throw at least 4 or 5 in a fight.
I've actually been able to go around with that myself twice or 3 times or something like that, and then you just. It's so fun, you just run in, you do random decays, you get. Plus, every hero that you hit, you get plus 180 HP, and you're like, hey, that's fun! Let's keep on going, and you go from like 1800 HP to 3200, and you're like, well, that's fun.
Yeah. Quite surprising to see Sudo here skipping the aura until he maxes the axes as well. I mean, I think they're going for this kind of lineup.
Yeah, ZXC, they're just diving beneath the tier 1 tower here on top as they get 2 kills. Shadow Fiend got 1, Resolution got 1, and it's gonna just transition into a tier 1 tower beautifully. No,
it looks like
in place.
Here I'm still didn't get that Empire actually 5-manning pretty much all the time, especially now with this mech.
Yeah, they're showing what you need to be done. Last game it was a little bit less shown on side of BRM. They didn't really use the mecha in the early game to the full advantage. Empire is showing how they do that. I said, do you really want to go full 5-man event? Yeah.
Blink
oh, it's
dagger.
Always scary when they have all their ultimates up. That's.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a creep. Oh no, that's the boar. Slowing up Nofir. Nofir might
just die. Oh, he's on the high ground.
Yeah, again, nicely placed, but this curse. Also nice, and now they just throw forwards the door. And this is Yoku. Nice. And so Yoku is just gonna get controlled up first. I wanna try and get him maybe, but yeah, their Nofir is just way easier to.
Oh, can you get the Fiend's Grip?
Yeah, there's Avalanche. There we go, there it comes out.
Oh, and if they get the skill, it's gonna be huge.
No resolution, not in time. They're gonna kill him off before he can do anything with the Lucent Beam Ears. No. Yeah, this is not gonna work out. Ultimate comes out from Luna as well, gets a kill with it. And now, Alola Dance gets lift up. Fade Bolt in one, maybe able to burst one down. Nice, no, he's gonna die. And that's four people down, an Empire in a sloppy retreat from them. As well, so
yeah, Vera would take a huge fight. It could have been just a tombstone committed for, you know, one support kill, but Yoku decides to stick around and try and help him, and yeah, just not respecting the toss. Beastmaster doesn't have a blink, but you know, toss is the poor man's blink dagger, and you know,
we saw it previous game and we see it now again.
Yeah. And Yoku should have just really abandoned his buddy and put on the hell out of there. Meanwhile though, Silence keeps farming and it's actually catching up. He's overtaken the hyena of that bounty room.
I completely whiffed on putting the net worth on, that's stupid. Sorry guys, it's 60 minutes in and now I put on the net worth. Well,
nothing says something about it in the chat. Okay, I'm good.
Of course I had the net worth on.
Yeah, I think one issue this game though is compared to the last game, they had Tiny Myth again going for this kind of space making build with the Blink Dagger, but he didn't manage to get very far and catch up in items. But this time it seems it's gonna be a bit harder, and Luna is really doesn't right click as hard as the Shadow Fiend does. So, yeah, their lineup is it's more heavily concentrated on magical damage, I feel. But then again, they do have the auras to compensate. Which, as Zoe starts getting levels now, he's gonna max his aura as well. I still feel like he should have maxed the aura before the axes. I don't think that great.
No, that actually dead. They get two kills actually here on mid as it was watching at the Beastmaster. Yoki isn't picking him up, just furthering his net worth lead here. He's gonna get his BKB as well fairly soon, meaning that. Well, they do have some ways to at least keep him locked down, feed scrape as well as he. Of course, Aurora is pretty nice to do it. So. It's still tough to do it. You think the BKB is here the correct. Yeah, he needs it. Like, there's not really a question about it. Yeah. I guess.
Yeah, I mean.
Silence getting a Shadowblade, where we'll at least try to go for it into a.
Oh, that's interesting. No, but here's the Avalanche does.
Silence able to get through it. Oh shit, I just accidentally put on the fucking console, you gotta be shitting me. Well, that was just. They're fighting everywhere. Totem is gonna get killed now on the high ground, as Yoku is still together with his friend. Eclipse comes out, not really killing off anybody here. ZXC, yeah, that doesn't really work out. He's still the Sprint West there. They're able to give the Yoku the Aegis here. He's gonna get his Mithril Hammer delivered. I don't know why, he has no space. So Alola Dance is
strange.
Close to his Link now as well. That would be a pretty nice pick
up. Oh, it's pick up the magic wand. Yeah, very strange fight there. Actually, the really big the Winter Wyvern is Arctic Burn. Allow them to get up on the cliff and scout out the tombstones so they could actually bring it down. Like it's a very big deal if they didn't have that. Oh, they also had a rocket to give vision, I guess. But and on top of that, Alola Dance managed to steal a tombstone and
he could also just put it on the yeah. He still has it though. It's not as nicely looking as the one is, and they actually completely spot his rotation out here with the hawk, so
yeah. For the Shadowblade on Silence, I'm not sure I agree with it. Like, normally I would say, yeah, Shadowblade is a pretty nice item on Jugger. But considering that Sadoi is rushing a Necro 3, and he almost has it.
Maybe, that's one of the... maybe he wants to go hunting for Luna. It does block her passive, so that's pretty nice.
No, yeah, if he manages to, yeah. If he goes for the full Silver Edge, Not sure if he's gonna get that right away though. Yeah, could be a nice choice. Also
Tiny
maybe
as
to
well.
get rid of the craggy exterior, yeah.
And the Beastmaster Arbor as well, though that's not the biggest thing to do. Ooh, yeah, they want to go for Air Exmo here. Tiny, lift him into the air. Hookshot from Resolution just hits a lower dance, but they should still be able to kill him off here, as he's just going to toss some damage back into lower dance before dying.
That kill, I'd say, does not really happen without the Tombstone. Just giving vision, guaranteeing the blink is continuously cancelled.
And now they have a blink toss ready on the side of Empire as well. So I'm pretty sure they should have spotted this one out, and they're not going to try and contest his tier 2, because this might end in tears for BRM.
The boy finally gets to Necro 3. He gets the tower.
20 minutes is still okay.
That's just a very nice time.
Oh, lift! Yes! What curse straight away? Okay, that's really overlapping here. So I might be able to turn this one around now, but nah. He's not.
Yeah.
There's going to be the Cold Embrace.
I mean, they're both instant spells, but you know, you never know if the other guy is falling quick enough. Plus, you don't know how much of the TP is left, so it's better to just be safe and spam him out both.
Now ZXC, this is gonna be the one of the most boring trade. Oh, maybe not. There's gonna get a totem. Now they're gonna try and turn this one to get ZXC alive. He's still alive here. This is gonna give up screen for now. As there's also Fierce Grip, ZXC actually walks back in. Now they see Silent coming up. They're just gonna get out on the totem, as I have a big red particle in the middle of it. What the hell is that?
Oh, the red pluses?
Yeah.
Yeah, very strange. I don't know. It happens to me all the time.
Well, okay.
Oh, Silent, well, gonna sneak up on Exmo.
He needs to use his ultimate. There we go. He's able to get it off and kill him. Pretty lucky that
quite
he got
lucky.
No craggy.
He even got a crit, yeah. He didn't get craggy, then he got a crit.
Lucky man, lucky man. Still, it wasn't even the end of his bounces, and he also had a Day Fury, so he should have gotten the kill anyhow.
And now Empire still have Aegis, so I feel like they have no reason to back off, and looks like they were gonna 5-man for the mid tower.
How long do they still have it though? It's still 3.5 minutes, so there's still some time left.
This is the second to last tier 2 tower left for Burium.
It's really nice if Empire can take this one up there, and they have really used the Aegis to nice potential. I don't think they will go for another tower, because they might be pushing it a little bit too far. They're not that
yeah.
Oh, they're actually pretty far ahead, 10k gold and 7.5k experience. But it's not high ground time yet, that's the one thing that's sure.
No, Eclipse is still cool on, but yeah, it is risky for sure. And they have no reason to risk things right now.
Yeah, if it goes wrong, everything goes wrong from just this one fight, then they... It is in the end, it's the easy route into the qualifier. Now it's still just the first one. If you can get through this one, then you're just a lot more happier. You don't have to go at it again tomorrow. So, yeah. Are you going to be joining in tomorrow again for the qualifier?
I'm going to be playing that one most likely.
That's it.
I was supposed to play this one too, but yeah, we had some unfortunate issues with one player. Initiation.
Yes, Dory is found. You're gonna go after him. There's gonna be the curse as well coming out. So Dory is still gonna take the fall here. And Silent is pretty much being controlled here by the Fiend's Grip really, really nicely. Oh, the Cold Embrace just in time to heal him up. And there comes Ragnarok. So it's pretty much to slow them all down. As it's still just a 1-4-0 trade.
Kind of a late break him, yeah. Change fight, but you know, Empire just come out ahead because there are so ahead in items as well. A lower dance is actually overtaken. Exmo as well as Luna.
Yeah, this is the one thing that that's so impressive about this Rubik. He always fights farm somehow. Like how he does it, it's impeccable. It's still pretty weird.
Mm-hmm. I can see Empire showing discipline here. Not
going too far.
Going
not
too far. Yep.
Retreating back S5, not going one by one, not leaving anybody behind, using Glimmer Caves, 4 steps, everything.
Yeah, and that fight, they committed actually quite a bit. They used the Winter's Curse to try and burst down the Beastmaster before he can get his roar. And he still got the roar before dying, but it didn't matter in the end. They're just very far ahead.
And yeah, they got a little bit
pretty
away
cool
over there. Oh, he's gonna look for a kill here, but this might not be too smart. I think he noticed like this is a little bit too much to go for.
I'm just waiting till he gets seen by something, but there's absolutely no vision on the Radiant side. Just look at it, they're playing in dark. Yasha.
There's a ward.
So is he gonna go back for Monte? I guess it's nice against Luna. As well as maybe make them wonder who's the real one. I guess it has its function.
Yeah, he's always the target of these roars and fiend's grips, so having extra juggers around could be nice.
That's it, there's also a lot of AoE, so it's gonna
And if he spins, then it's pretty obvious which is the real one.
And he maxed, he went for the newer build with more points into the Blade Fury, so... Whoa! Damage to the melee barracks! Well, it's pretty much healed before you're 20 units away. That's like... That's really just...
Hashtag worth it.
Oh my god. Silent contribution to the push.
He's searching down, it's just showing that he's not afraid.
Yeah, why don't you just put it on the ranged Rex? Like, at least it's something, like, it stays.
Yeah, Ogre Club, he's probably gonna finish with the Sanji Asha and then possibly disassemble into that Silver Edge you're talking about.
Yeah, maybe keep both. Who knows?
It's kinda weird to see him still holding a value branch at 25 minutes. And who needs TP scrolls anyway?
Yeah, you call it GG branch for a reason. In the end, he's gonna sell all his items, walk around with 6 sticks.
What if we see him survive with 5 HP this fight, and then that's when we know what the branch is for?
Yeah, like on 1 HP would even be perfect, like, and like yeah, that's 17, that 18 HP that you get from it, it's just wrong. Yeah, so this curse comes out on Toon, it's really nice, they're able to lock him down. Now ZXC takes a fall as well, that's actually 2 down already, they need to buy back instantly now, as there's a Fiend Script coming up, but it wasn't really kept there long enough, as they're gonna go for the ultimate here from the Lunar Eclipse, but they're just walking off and they run into all the creeps, doesn't really do anything. As the roar was stalling and just put back into use on the Radiant side, there's BRM. Take 1 fall, 2 fall, 3 fall, and that's gonna be it. It's in the end, it's actually 4 deaths plus die back. GG.
They could try to keep playing, but I mean, Tiny is still no Aghanims, so dealing with these creeps is gonna be too hard.
Yeah, they tried it again with the mid Tiny, but this time Empire was prepared. This didn't catch him, of course. Yoki played really diligence in that one. Yeah, this is a pretty fresh game in comparison to the other two matches.
Yeah.
26 minutes. So, yeah. Well, we're gonna have a full best of three here. Empire needs to go the entire stretch as well as BRM. One of these two will go to the qualifier for the major in Frankfurt. This is the series Road to Frankfurt for Empire, pretty much. Is with me joining was @StrikeDota. I'm @Sender_Dota here on the Swiss DC channel. Make sure to follow us everywhere. All those good times, things, and I guess we'll see you back at the third match then. Till then, everybody.